Where is fairness bred? Is it in the heart? Is it in the head? If it's in the heart, I want to give everybody here every possible chance, every courtesy I can muster, an extension of a delay until final judgment or whatever you want to call that admin crap. Everything I can do. That's what I want to do. That's the heart speaking, because if it were me, I would want to be afforded every reasonable chance, and then some. That way, if you make a decision, there's plenty of foundation. You don't have to second guess stuff as much. Okay, but if it's in the head, well, yes, technically enough has happened. Enough happened months ago. Enough happened 9 years ago when the site started, if you really want to be technical and go by the letter of the TOS, which I prefer to go by the spirit of our own site rules and guidelines, which, if anybody wants to point it out to me, go right ahead, which are governed by Ning. So, Ning TOS, everybody has broken the TOS. All parties involved have broken the TOS years ago. So, yeah, that's not terribly helpful, you see. So, we have to take it in another direction. Recently, now, you can say stuff is ongoing, so if it happens to settle down for a while, do you call the person who mentions it again suddenly recreating everything, or do you say, well, there's an inevitable wave pattern to this, so when the wave goes down, the wave is going to come up. Whoever happens to be riding the top of the wave doesn't mean it's the hangman's target up there, just means that's the way it's going. So that's one way to look at it. Or you could say, as was recently suggested in a blog, once you say, this is it, anybody who does anything, 2 weeks off, you know, 2 week suspension, or whatever, month suspension, whatever seems appropriate, you could do that. But then, you run the risk of suspension after suspension. Whether it's the same person getting suspended, as we've seen, we have a record here with one particular notable member who is a year and a half, probably a little more, has been suspended during his time here. A year and a half suspension total. You know, this is like a few suspensions combined, but a year and a half or so, maybe even approaching 2 years, actually. We have that, and we can keep on going with that, and we can keep on doing the crap that is attached to that. And then on the other side, there are members who say, why was he suspended? I don't think he should. This is, of course, after the fact. I don't think he should have been suspended. What was the big deal? You know, that happens too. You're called upon to make a decision, and then somebody who had not contributed up to that point comes in and says, well, why did you do that? I've seen so much that I can't mention because it's not fair to mention within the context of this argument. I wouldn't want to perpetuate it, for example, and it's hard to resist correcting people, but I know that a lot of that stuff is just going to make it go longer, so I'm hoping that things can be worked out, which is what I would ideally like to have that happen. If it doesn't, of course, there are other predictable recourses, and these are what I would like to avoid. So if anybody's wondering, oh, well, why didn't he just do this? Why didn't he just do that? Well, number one, in this situation, it is not clear-cut. You can see something and say, oh, well, it is clear-cut because of this, and I guarantee you, I'll point you to other things that totally offset that. I guarantee you, that no matter which side you pick here, and you say, well, it's clear-cut because of this, I can have something to show you that will totally offset that. So there's that. Ultimately, it's a decision that, you know, if I don't make, then I'll tell you what's going to happen. Somebody's going to leave, like has been mentioned, been threatened, or been promised, or whatever you want to call it. Somebody's going to leave, and that could be their way of saying, ha, last word, you know, last word, boom, out the door. But it's also devaluing everybody here. You know, if you make a claim that, oh, nobody here is safe and people are creeping around and doing all this stuff, and then you treat everybody like shit by not sticking up, but by not doing anything, by just leaving, then yeah, that makes a big statement, perhaps more than you intend by doing that. So I would just, you know, offering that as some friendly advice. If it enrages you, I'm sorry, that wasn't my intent or purpose here. If we stay and we deal with what's here, there's nothing so irreparable. These are people bickering who've bickered for years. And I guarantee you, if Zen Archer and Argent were still around, those guys would have gone at it multiple times in the years since they've been gone. We would have not, they would have eclipsed the stuff that's going on here at their greater moments, I guarantee you, because we've seen it before. And this is all, this is all sort of Battlestar Galactica type thing. Seen it before. It's happened before. It's happened again. It's just a mirror into infinity. I know how this goes. I try to make little adjustments each time, but I generally play it the same way. And that is, I apply an overabundance of caution and fairness. Caution in not jumping to decisions. Fairness in giving every possible chance beyond what almost anybody would give for chances. Yeah, I like to do one or two more than just that. And it's totally valid to say, why are you doing that? You shouldn't do that. You should do this. You should act upon this. You should act this way. I get it. And it's not the atmosphere I want to foster. To call upon administration ideally doesn't happen. The second choice, it's an absolute last resort. If you have that kind of just do anything and I'll press the button attitude, you're repeatedly calling upon administration. You know, I can count on definitely two, possibly one hand, the amount of report and issues I've received in the 8+ years that this site has been around. When I was an administrator, not just on that one other site, but on a couple of other sites for Ning, that number coming in a day happened before. Eight and a half years of reporting issues on Voasis have come in a fucking day on not just that one other site, but two other sites. Now, why? Now, the why here is supremely important, because that's the kernel of knowledge that could be used to potentially avoid this or minimize it as much as possible. And I think the why is you have a too proactive a stance in administration. And it's born out of an eagerness, a wanting to do good. There's usually lots of good intentions behind there. But I'll tell you, when it happens, you're setting a tone. You're setting a stage. The table is set for the community to think that now, when they contact you, boom, you know, Deus Ex Machina is going to happen, and the lightning bolt is going to come out of the sky and solve all their problems. That's not the way life works, and ideally that's not the way an online community I'm a member of would work. So instead of calling for Zeus to strike somebody down with a thunderbolt, and then the next person, and then the next, it doesn't stop with just one. You know, I've heard this line before, just get rid of this person, and the site is fantastic. And guess what? The people who said that usually later say, just get rid of this other person here, and the site is fantastic. It's, as you can see, it's a self-defeating sort of stance. So, in the question of community, why do I do things the way I do? I understand if you don't agree with them, totally get it. But the reason why that I do it this way is because there's an action, there's a movement, and there's a purpose in the way people deal with each other. And to halt that and stop it and suddenly make a ruling is to discount the ultimate potential of that purpose, of those interactions. Now, what do I mean by the ultimate potential? Well, if you make a ruling, you have eliminated the possibility that anybody will come to an understanding or resolution. You've created the resolution. You've made somebody go away, and that's it. I like the idea of working through something like this and hopefully coming. Okay, so there was a 10-minute recording limit on that. I like the idea of working through something like this and hopefully coming to an understanding. So the parties involved, yeah, they can go at it like cats and dogs, but if you haven't entertained the system of constant reporting, just think about that. Apply it in a real-world scenario. I wonder what country of the past might have encouraged constant reporting on things that were going on. I'm sure you can think of at least one, probably more. If you don't have that atmosphere and people aren't, you know, hitting the issue button and saying, do this, oh, he called me a silly ninny and he hurt my feelings and made me cry, and all that stuff. If that's not happening, then I believe you're getting a truer interaction with the community, because you're taking out the equation of administration and you're having people together. And that's really what a social, that's why you're here, right? You come to a social network for people, not for governance or administration. So I like to give every last chance for a situation like that to find some resolution. Doesn't have to be a great resolution either. Just some sort of way that the parties involved can get on with it and live their lives and do their thing, rather than the cutoff point of suspension and then feelings fester. And we've all seen this before, right? Suspensions have been necessary from time to time. Usually it's the same person who gets suspended, right? Now, there's another fantastic argument. You could say, since it's usually the same person who gets suspended, why not just get rid of that person? Another valid argument. And up until, you know, whatever it was, a year ago or whatever that was, maybe a little more now, I thought I had gotten rid of that person and I did not intend to bring them back. And then the shootings in Vegas happened, the hotel shootings at the concert, you know, and it just seemed so silly. You know, it had already been almost a year that that person had been suspended, and that stuff was on the TV that day, and I said to myself, it's ridiculous to carry this on into infinity. I mean, nobody is totally bad. Nobody is totally good. Shades of gray abound. And so brought him back. And now people can easily say, look, he's at it again. It's happening again. Get rid of him for good. Although I have gotten some input and nobody has said get rid of him for good. They have said some stuff, but not that. So counterbalancing that. I'm trying to be fair here, and I'm trying to lay things out and present them as clearly as I can. But first, a drink. Just soda. Okay, counterbalancing that is the idea that to each according to their own ability, okay? Very important concept. And I think it should be applied in some community situations. Not all, some. I mean, if you're having a video contest, obviously, to each according to their ability, you aren't going to give the worst video the prize because the worst video is the best video that that person ever made. Okay? But in other areas where somebody has shown not only a marked improvement, but a willingness to try, a desire to do better, I think it has to count for something. Otherwise, it's like one of those little tragedies of life. And I don't want to be 90 years old sitting in a rocking chair saying, geez, I remember that guy. He was trying and I just got rid of him. You know, I don't want to do that. I don't want to be that guy. I'd rather be the 90-year-old guy sitting in the rocking chair that says, I kept giving him chance after chance after chance, and he just fucked it up. What the hell can I do? You know, I'd rather be that guy. So you have that on the other side, and that is a potent counterbalance, because people have different abilities. My own social interactive ability is questionable in some circumstances. Just because I can turn on the camera and start talking to you doesn't mean I can go out and chat up the grocery guy or whatever. Doesn't apply. So, to each according to their own ability, offsets. Oh, it's always this guy. Well, yes. Yes, it could always be that guy. But is it getting further apart? Is he trying more? You know, is more good stuff happening than bad? You know, all sorts of things. So there's that. Okay. Now, I don't want, obviously, this is going to be a 20-minute video or until the camera runs out. I'll tell you what. This will be the last. Camera runs out here after 10 minutes. I won't come back on. This will just be 20 minutes tops. So it could end in mid-sentence, and you'll just have to be cool with that. Hopefully, it won't be at the end, in the middle of a great thought or anything. We'll see. I've seen it year after year. The personnel changes, okay? And it is some, in my opinion, some weak-ass shit to suddenly stir shit and then demand something happen. And then when that exact thing doesn't happen, say, I'm getting the fuck out of here. Nobody's safe. Nobody can do anything. Everything's horrible and it's all going to die. It's going to die in a cesspool of filth and shit. I've made my proclamation. Goodbye, you fuckers. I just don't, you know, I don't get it. I don't like it. I'd like to avoid it. But it happens. We've seen it happen before. My friend, who I had a falling out with a couple years ago that was totally bizarre, but I can somehow understand it, I guess. My friend out in California, who's a bit eccentric, was on this site until one particular time. He said that this member was the biggest problem. If I just got rid of this member, and this is a different member than the last member to him who was the biggest problem that I needed to get rid of and everything's perfect. Well, the action that he wanted did not happen. And as a protest, oh, that's it, oh, I'm gone. We do that, I'm never. So, gone. To his credit though, you know, I thought he'd just keep coming back and back and back, but he hasn't come back. So he felt very strongly about that. I don't think I would have done what he wanted, which was just to eliminate somebody. And I regret the fact that he made that decision, but I have to respect his decision. I've seen it again now, just recently, with one particular member involved in the skirmishes, saying, well, nobody's safe here, I'm leaving, I can't trust anything. Whatever that was. I'm not trying to mock it, I'm just trying to impart an idea of how lightly that approach handles anything compared to the greater reality of dealing with it. You know, now you can say, oh, I've tried this and I've tried that. But if all you do is yell in the way that you try it, you aren't giving an honest chance for anybody to learn from that, really. You're just putting on a display, you're putting on a big show. And too many times, that's what it seems to be about. There are facts that exist, but they get embellished and added on and shifted, and you fabricate attachments and pieces for them, so that it's like a transformer thing. Like somewhere in the middle there was a fact, and then this guy made a big suit of armor for it, and this guy did a Viking helmet with horns, and this guy did 8 mechanical arms that just sort of swing everywhere. And by the time you're done looking at it, you don't know where the truth is anymore. It's just this big monster farting and swirling around and everything. So I would like to think that if you try to focus on the core of facts within these things, you'll see that at no point could you say, oh, well, this party here, clearly this party needs to go because, like I said, I guarantee you, I can show you something else, totally offsets that. So we've come to a full circle. Maybe it won't even take 20 minutes. There's more that I wanted to say, but as it so often happens, when you turn on the camera, the thoughts form their own lines, and they do their own formations, and they march the way they want to march sometimes. And that's how it's come out. My intent was to level with you and to give you thoughts and reactions and feelings, and yes, to selfishly justify the position I so often take when these situations arise. Cheers.